signs of gum disease that you cannot ignore from a doctor of dental surgery. First sign is loose teeth. And listen to this case. I had a patient who was very young patient in the age of 26 to 27, and he had completely perfect teeth. They had no cavities, no issues whatsoever, but he came with a complaint of some of them were loose. And I do a full mouth examination, and what I actually find out is that every single one of his teeth is completely loose to the extent that they're not even restorable. Right? And I look into this patient's medical history prior to admitting him, and guess what? He's diabetic, and there is a link between gum disease and diabetes, and it goes in full circle in a sense that diabetes may have a link with gum disease, and as well as having gum disease may have a link with diabetes itself. So they go in full circle. The second sign of gum disease is bleeding gums. Healthy gums do not bleed even when you brush or floss your teeth. If you're doing them properly and you don't have gum disease, your gums should not bleed. So if your gums do bleed during flossing or routine brushing or for no reason actually, that may be a sign of gum inflammation. Third sign of gum disease is reddish gums. Now the natural color of your gums is actually pinkish to light pinkish. And also in certain populations like the darker skin or the African population, they may have naturally more brown gums, and that is due to the melanin pigmentation. However, if you have gums that are becoming reddish in color, this may give a hint of gum inflammation. Another sign of gum disease is swollen or puffy gums, and this is not to be mixed with or confused with the drug-induced gingival, meaning gums enlargement, and this can be due to primarily three categories of drugs: immunosuppressants such as cyclosporin and antihypertensive drugs, in specific calcium channel blockers. And the third category are anticonvulsants such as phenytoin. So these types of drugs do not necessarily have to cause gingival enlargement, however they can be contributing factors. And this shows when I look into the medical history of some patients who present to the clinic with gingival enlargement, especially generalized, meaning all over your mouth. Another sign of gum disease is actually pus. Pus is that liquid or gooey material that constitutes of bacteria, dead white blood cells and bacteria byproducts and other components, and it can be oozing from the gingiva, indicating a sign of gum disease or gum inflammation. Bone loss is also a sign of gum disease, and it's what contributes also to the loose teeth that we mentioned earlier. Now, bone loss can happen in primarily two patterns. That can be vertical bone loss or horizontal bone loss. Also, bone loss as a result of gum disease can be either localized to a particular area or region, or it can be generalized, which is more serious. Another sign of gum disease is teeth misalignment or changes in the arrangement of your teeth. Now, this can be potentially a sign of gum disease and can be also due to other causes, but it is to be taken into consideration. Teeth misalignment also means that there are either spaces that are abnormally created between your teeth that were non-existent before, or there's a change in the way that you bite, or it can also mean that there was the change in the way that your teeth, the anterior teeth, the front teeth, also overlap. Gum recession is also another sign of gum disease. And it's basically your gums, these pinkish tissues, are pulling away from your teeth. And it may go to the extent of exposing the root of your tooth. Now, this can be extremely problematic because that recession is not really reversible unless if there was an intervention from healthcare professional. And usually that intervention is actually a surgical intervention. Another thing to take into consideration is that when gum recession happens, it can result to a tooth sensitivity because the roots are far more sensitive compared with the crown, which is like sort of the whitish area or more visible area of your tooth. Gum or gingival pockets are another sign of gum disease. Now, naturally, there is a small pocket between your tooth and the pinkish area or your gums, and that is measured 2 to 3 millimeter normally. The problem is if it extends beyond that, then that indicates that there is something abnormal, most likely, that's going on there. Also, this sign of gum disease can be measured by your dentist or the gum specialist or the periodontist because they will use a special instrument that's called a periodontal probe that has many designs and different types to measure the depth of that pocket, determine if the depth is within the normal range of a gingival pocket or if it's extending beyond that. Another sign of gum disease is bad breath, also termed halitosis. And this occurs for a multitude of reasons, but one of them is poor oral hygiene or not taking care of your mouth. The American Dental Association recommends brushing your teeth 2 times a day for 2 minutes and changing your toothbrush every 3 to 4 months, or to change your toothbrush more often if the toothbrush becomes less effective or it just looks more frayed. Thanks for watching the video. Make sure to subscribe, leave a comment and a like, and see you in the next video. Peace.